Hi, it's me. I was inspired by watching some of the other people with my illness's videos and their brutal honesty, and I try to hide. Sorry, I'm about ready to burst into tears. Because I get judged so much if I'm honest. Before I got sick, I was bodybuilding for 10.5 years. In high school, those of you who knew me know that I was like hyperactive and I did 50 million things at the same time. I was never a lazy person. So I owned my own landscape company and I was successful too before I got sick. And I was bodybuilding and I was a single mom at the same time. When I got sick, it was at the end of a really brutal, bad divorce. And yeah, I've been through lots of different abuses in my life. And the doctors say that they think it's years of having so much stress. So they're saying it's post-traumatic stress. And then I got strep throat year after year until I got my tonsils out. So I'm really unsure when it all totally began. I was diagnosed in 98. It was after I got my first divorce. So a typical day for me is I will clean. Well, I'll get up at 7:30 in the morning and wake up with my 7-year-old and get her ready and off to school. And then if I'm having a good day, I'll get the dishes done and maybe some laundry, but I can't get all the dishes done at one time. I have to wash and then I have to lay down, either lay on the couch and watch TV. I try not to take naps during the day because we go through cycles where we can't sleep, and so I really try not to take naps. That, and it makes me depressed to sleep all the time. So I have pain all the time that's through my neck and shoulders. Sometimes I get vertigo really bad. I have orthostatic intolerance, so my neck swells up and the blood flow doesn't go to my brain. You can make a joke about it. I do all the time, saying I don't get enough air to my brain, because it's true. Sometimes I don't. So as far as the landscaping goes, I miss it. And I would love to get back to work, but to pull weeds, sometimes I have to sit. In order to stand up, I've got to stand there for a few minutes because my blood pressure drops and I'll pass out. I make jokes about it. It's like I make jokes about when people say, well, so how are you doing? I'm tired. I don't know. I wish I could just say I'm fine. But the truth of the matter is, I'm not. I'm struggling and winters are the hardest. I don't have any help. I take care of my shopping, my house, my kids all by myself. And sometimes I get overwhelmed. I'll be honest, I'll get overwhelmed. Very few people have seen me on my bad, really bad days. Mark Stroud's one of them. Bless your heart, Mark. He sure helps me out a lot. Sometimes he'll just show up and do the dishes. And it means a lot to me. Oh, I'm gonna cry. So, and lately I'm going through a bad period since I had to wake up at 5:30 to take my daughter after she got hit to the bus stop. So today's the first day that she went without me driving her because I just couldn't handle getting up and doing that because I've been down all weekend and apparently I'm down again today. So the doctors try to throw meds at us and then they all have side effects. So it's a vicious cycle. Well, I'm pretty tired and I can't think of what else to tell you now. And I don't want to be a whiner. I just want to be honest. I miss my life. I miss bodybuilding. I miss working and being able to take care of everything myself and try to be super mom. All right. Well, I'll try to do more updates. And thank you for those people with chronic fatigue who gave me the courage and strength to do this video, because it's really hard to let people see the side of me because I hide it and try to laugh all the time. All right, God bless.